أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما. يقول جل وعلا بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم مثلهم كمثل الذي استوقد نارا فلما أضاءت ما حولها ذهب الله بنورهم وتركهم في ظلمات لا يبصرون. We talked in the past few weeks about the two groups of people with the coming of the message of Islam, the believers and the disbelievers. And then we mentioned that a third group emerged in the Medina headed by Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul. And this is when the Muslims became strong. So the hypocrites emerged in order to protect themselves and to protect their wealth, thinking that practicing hypocrisy is going to spare them from the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is going to enable them to deceive Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who knows everything that they overtly display and they covertly hide. Or thinking that they're going to deceive the believers who see with the guiding light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed them about the traits of the hypocrites. So the hypocrites are not a mystery to them. But here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in addition to talking about the hypocrites, He's given us examples. And He mentions in the Quran that these examples none really comprehend and understand except those who are people of knowledge. And He tells us, يَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا ضُرِبَ مَثَلٌ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ. So every time you see an example, a parable that is given to us in the Quran, we ought to pay close attention to it. And we ought to try to understand as much as we can, grasp onto as much as knowledge as we can. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives two examples to the hypocrites. The first of which I mentioned in the ayah, أَوْ كَصَيِّبٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَثَلُهُمْ كَمَثَلِ الَّذِي اسْتَوْقَدَ نَارًا. The example of those hypocrites, like the example of those who lit a fire in order for them to be able to see. فَلَمَّا أَضَاءَتْ مَا حَوْلَهُ. When this fire lightened all that surrounded, ذَهَبَ اللَّهُ بِنُورِهِمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken their light, وَالْعِيَادِ بِاللَّهِ. وَتَرَكَهُمْ فِي ظُلُمَاتٍ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ. And He has left them in darknesses upon darknesses that they cannot see. Notice that the word nur is always mentioned in the Quran in the singular form, because the nur of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one. The guiding light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one. The straight path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one. However, darknesses and misguidance and so on and so forth comes in many flavors and in many layers. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that they have some light. When they are with the believers, they see the truth. When they sit with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they grasp onto some of the guidance. However, when they revert back to their heads of hypocrisy and their heads of kufr, what happens? They go back into their state of doubt and their state of hesitation and their state of disbelief and so on and so forth. In the second example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Al kasayibin." Before that, He says, "Summun bukmun umyun fahum la yarji'un." Indeed, they are deaf, dumb, and blind, and they will never go back to the state of iman that they claimed in the first place. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran that the worst of animals, or the worst of dawab on the face of the earth, are as-sum al-bukm, those who can never speak nor they can hear. They cannot hear the guidance and they cannot speak the truth. Al kasayibin min as-sama', as-sayib here, according to the interpretation of some of the scholars, is more like either the dark clouds or, you know, the rain. أَوْ كَصَيِّبٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فِيهِ ظُلُمَاتٌ وَرَعْدٌ وَبَرْخٌ. In it there are darknesses. And رَعْد, which is the thunder and lightning. أَوْ كَصَيِّبٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فِيهِ ظُلُمَاتٌ وَرَعْدٌ وَبَرْخٌ يَجْعَلُونَ أَصَابِعَهُمْ فِي آذَانِهِمْ مِنَ الصَّوَاعِقِ حَذَرَ الْمَوْتِ. They put their fingers into their ears, fearing the صَاعِقَ. Notice, In the beginning of the ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about thunder and lightning. In the latter part of the ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about sayyib. A man by name Ali Mansur, who is a physicist, who is a Muslim physicist, and he's been working for the past 30 years on, you know, pondering and bringing out into the light and the understanding of common people like us the scientific miracles of the Quran. And he says that the sayyib is different from, there's really no equivalent word to it in English. The sayyib is different from lightning. He said lightning is what we see. You know, the lightning that we see, and then we hear the thunder, because obviously the light is faster than the speed of sound. He said the sayyib is a part of the air that is charged with the electrical charges that actually deviates from the path of lightning as it comes close and as draws nearer to the earth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strikes with it whoever He decrees. And that's why we see people struck with lightning. They're actually not struck with lightning. They're struck with a branch that deviates, that doesn't have a smell. You cannot smell it, you cannot see it. So it's really invisible to the naked eye. And by way of scientific evidence, they were able to explore that. Because lightning is what we basically, we use these poles, metal poles, to charge through the earth in order to prevent, strikes of lightning. But the sayyib is different. يَجْعَلُونَ أَصَابِعَهُمْ فِي آذَانِهِمْ مِنَ الصَّوَاعِقِ حَذَرَ الْمَوْتِ so that they cannot die, or they would not die. وَاللَّهُ مُحِيطٌ بِالْكَافِرِينَ Where are they going to go? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has encompassed all with His actions, with His vision, with His abilities. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَكَادُ الْبَرْقُ يَخْطَفُ أَبْصَارَهُمْ الْبَرْقُ is the strong light, it's like a parable for the strong light of Iman. يَكَادُ الْبَرْقُ يَخْطَفُ أَبْصَارَهُمْ It will almost take their eyesight away. يَكَادُ الْبَرْقُ يَخْطَفُ أَبْصَارَهُمْ كُلَّمَا أَضَاءَ لَهُمْ مَشَوْ فِيهِ So when they're around the believers, around the Prophet ﷺ, they walk in this light. وَإِذَا أَظْلَمَ عَلَيْهِمْ When they revert to the heads of hypocrisy and their heads of kufr and disbelief, وَإِذَا أَظْلَمَ عَلَيْهِمْ قَامُوا They stop. They back into a state of hesitation and doubt and so on and so forth. وَإِذَا أَظْلَمَ عَلَيْهِمْ قَامُوا وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَذَهَبَ بِسَمْعِهِمْ وَأَبْصَارِهِمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ Had Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willed, He would have taken their eyesights and He would have taken their ability to hear. In other words, He would have obscured their ability to listen or see any guidance whatsoever. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses all mankind by saying, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ All people of mankind, with the coming of the Prophet ﷺ, people have divided into two different parts. The special group, which is the group of the believers. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses all mankind, He says, Ya ayyuhan nas. Why? Because this is ummat al-da'wah. This is the ummah of da'wah. This is the ummah that the Prophet ﷺ was sent to in order to give da'wah. Ya ayyuhan nas, u'budu rabbakum. U'budu rabbakum, worship your Lord. And here the word Rabb is used because neither the hypocrite or the disbeliever or the mushrik dispute the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Rabb. And we mentioned that the word Rabb means the creator, the sustainer, the disposal of affairs, the one who bestows his rizq and bounties upon us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, commands him, وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ So there is no denial that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Rabb. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding them, says, since I am the Rabb, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ رَبَّكُمْ Then worship me. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ عُبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ The creator of all, you, the ones who preceded you, and the one who will succeed you, all mankind. وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ Perhaps you would achieve a status of taqwa that will earn you a share of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you will end up in a paradise. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us of these favors. الَّذِي جَعَلَكُمْ الْأَرْضَ فِرَاشًا وَالسَّمَاءَ بِنَاءً وَأَنزَلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً فَأَخْرَجَ بِهِ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ رِزْقًا لَكُمْ فَلَا تَجْعَلُوا لِلَّهِ أَنْدَادًا وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ So do not make partners and equals to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon knowledge. In other words, you are not making such a claim out of ignorance, but out of knowledge, out of certainty, after confessing that none is the Rabb, none is the creator, none is the sustainer, none that is the store and the disposal of affairs, the store of bounties and the disposal of affairs, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then do not make equal partners to Him. Do not make equal partners to Him. يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون الذي جعل لكم الأرض فراشا والسماء بناء وأنزل من السماء ماء فأخرج به من الثمرات رزقا لكم فلا تجعلوا لله أندادا وأنتم تعلمون وإن كنتم في ريب. So here, if there is any doubt left after all of that, وإن كنتم في ريب مما نزلنا على عبدنا, from that which we have revealed upon our slave محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, فأتوا بسورة من مثله. If you claim that these are the words of Satan and the words of a poet and the words of a crazy person and so on and so forth, then you have the obligation as masters of the Arabic language. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not challenge people who do not speak the Arabic language with the Quran. I mean, they are included in the challenge, but he challenged the masters of the language. فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِّن مِثْلِهِ. And we know that Surah Al-Kawthar is barely 3 ayat, 10 words. فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِّن مِثْلِهِ وَادْعُوا شُهَدَاءَكُم مِّن دُونِ اللَّهِ, and bring you witnesses aside from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا, if you cannot, وَلَمْ تَفْعَلُوا, and you will not be able to. You will not be able to. فَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ. Then have taqwa, put a fear in your heart that does not reach the level of desperation. In other words, a fear in our heart as believers does not allow us to reach a level of desperation that we have no hopes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And a sense of security by way of our iman and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and by way of our deeds should not allow us to feel safe and secure from the makr and the plot of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي وَقُدُوهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ. Now imagine, وَلِيَعَذُ بِاللَّهِ, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us, a fire that is fueled by people. Not only that, is fueled by rocks. Can you light up a fire that will make a rock melt? So the rock is not actually a fuel of the fires of this dunya. But we see that an example is given to us in the volcanoes, that these rocks come in the form of lava. They're such at a high temperature that they melt. The lava of the hereafter is far different. It's just an example for us. فَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ والحجارة أعدت للكافرين وبشر الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات أن لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار. And give the good news of those who believe and do righteous deeds. Notice Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, every time he mentions the word believe in the Quran, the creed, it's become rather evident. He does not say الذين آمنوا بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر إجمالا وتفصيلا, you know, collectively and in details. No, he mentions that because iman has become readily known to everybody. What does it mean to believe? And iman by itself, as we know, is not accepted. It has to be followed with righteous deeds. الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات أن لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks of gardens of Eden, paradise, underneath which rivers flow, that has already been prepared, that our Prophet ﷺ had already seen and he has already told us about. And so is the hellfire wal-iyadu billah, that's u'iddat lil-kafirin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already prepared it and has mentioned in the hadith that on judgment day 70,000 angels are dragging this fire wal-iyadu billah. And if it was to unleash or they lose the control of this fire, it will engulf everything in existence. We also learn from the hadith that if one drop وَالْعِيَادَ بِاللَّهِ from the hellfire or from, you know, the secretions of the people of the hellfire to descend on earth, that this earth will cease to be a suitable place for living. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning us right off the start. So the issue of Islam, iman, and righteous deeds comes between two parameters: do and stay away from. Acts of permissibility and obligations and acts of prohibitions and dislikes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those are rewarded by a jannah, عَرْضُهَا السَّمَوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ, and the others are rewarded by an eternal, not a life or a death, in the hellfire, وَالْعِيَادَ بِاللَّهِ. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who listen to the words of wisdom and follow the best of it. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the understanding of Islam and Iman. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us to live as Muslims and to die as believers. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ar-ridaa ba'da al-qadaa wa barda al-hayati ba'da al-mamat wa al-nazari ila wajhi al-kareem fi ghayri dharra'in mudurra wa la fitnatin mudilla innahu waliyu dhalika wa al-qadiru alayh wa al-akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.